Good afternoon, New Orleans.
Good afternoon.
Good to be with our fellow citizens and elected officials, those who will be speaking and those who are present to support this effort. I'm Pastor Sean Anglum of First Grace United Methodist Church and of Together New Orleans. Can we hear it for Together New Orleans?
Yeah.
We are here for the reason we're always here. We're here for each other and for our city. And we are here today to ask the State Board of Commerce and Industry and Governor Edwards to support the decisions of our local elected officials, our city council members, our school boards, and the sheriff, and to abide by the decision that has been made by the governor and by our elected officials to respect local decisions. We're also here in the season of Lent. And one thing the church teaches us about the season of Lent is it's a time of holding yourself accountable. And today we're here to hold Folgers accountable. Folgers is the leading coffee sold in America. They made $1.1 billion in 2022. And they still owe the city of New Orleans and our public schools and public school children and our city services $5.1 million in back taxes. 2 years ago, Folgers applied, that is, they asked for an exemption to those taxes from property taxes on $69.1 million in new property investments. Because of the efforts of Together New Orleans with our governor and local officials, in 2016, the way those exemptions are granted is through local entities, city council, school board, sheriffs. They have to approve those tax exemptions because, as we know, they directly affect our life together here in New Orleans. The city council unanimously said no to those exemptions. The local school board unanimously said no. The sheriff said no. 2 years later, here we are, and Folgers has yet to pay its overdue property tax. This affects our life together and how we can be a thriving city. 2 years later now, here we are, and Folgers is trying to circumvent the decision of our local officials and appeal to the Board of Commerce and Industry and our governor, asking them to disregard and overrule the decision of our local officials. We are respectfully and forcefully saying, Governor and Board of Commerce and Industry, respect the city of New Orleans. Respect the city council's decision. Respect the deliberation of our school boards and of our sheriffs and their decision to say no to those exemptions. We gather today to say enough is enough. 24 months have passed. We now want to invite some of our elected officials to come forward, and we begin with School Board Vice President Carlos Zurbagon. Can we hear it for Carlos?
Thank you, everyone.
Yeah, I'm Carlos Luis Zurbagon, Vice President of the Orleans Parish School Board. And I think, doesn't need to be said, but I'm gonna say it anyway. Everyone knows that the New Orleans public schools have been chronically underfunded basically forever. We have an extremely high teacher turnover rate. One of the reasons why is because we cannot pay the teachers what they deserve to ask them to stay. Everyone knows that these days there's a crisis in many communities of our youth. And because the Folgers company will not pay the taxes that they are owed, we cannot hire the same number of counselors and interventionists we need because of that reason. The school board voted unanimously to have them pay their taxes. They've been going through all kinds of minutia and tricks not to pay their taxes. I would ask Folgers to understand this is not a good look. If you're a large, profitable corporation and you won't pay what is owed to our high poverty schools so we can uplift our children to live an equitable and prosperous life. Yeah. We're asking it to stand. to the Board of Commerce and Industry, we're asking that this come to an end, come to a conclusion, that you respect the will of the local elected officials and our responsibility to take care of our communities, to make sure that they are okay, that they are whole. Folgers needs to do their part. With that, then, I will pass it off to Olin Parker, the president of the school board. He will speak next.
Thank you very much, Carlos. As he mentioned, my name is Olin Parker. I'm the president of the Orleans Parish School Board. Carlos, Vice President Zervigon, I know you'll be representing the school board in Baton Rouge next week, and we appreciate your leadership on this issue. I'm also, on behalf of the board, grateful to our city council, grateful to our sheriff, for their leadership on this issue, because we are united in this. Now, the school board unanimously voted to deny Folgers' applications for tax exemption, quite simply because we need the money for our schools, because we need the money for our students, because we need the money for our students. When we learned as a board that Folgers was asking for an appeal, we were again unified in our response. Our response is the same as it was 2 years ago. Thank you. Our response is the same as it was 2 years ago, regardless of whether or not Folgers chooses to ignore it. Time is running out. The students of our city need expanded access to mental health services. We need funds to combat chronic absenteeism that we're seeing post-COVID. We need funds to combat the learning loss that we saw post-COVID. And it's time for Folgers to do their part. It's time for the governor and the Board of Commerce and Industry to respect the decisions of our locally elected school board, our locally elected sheriff, and our locally elected city council. I want to thank everyone who came out today, all of our colleagues on the board, Ms. Leela Eames, Dr. Donala Batiste, Mr. Ethan Ashley, and to all of the community advocates and members of Together New Orleans, we are grateful for your support in this, for the support of our students, and I will now turn it over to a representative of our city council. Sorry, I will turn it over, to Dave Cash, the president of the United Teachers of New Orleans.
Thank you. Hi. Have you all seen the slick ad that Folgers produced reintroducing themselves to New Orleans, right, to the world? In that ad, they proudly claim New Orleans as their hometown, right? Which means they're a citizen of New Orleans, like us, right? And they're our neighbor. So I was a social studies teacher for a long time, and I taught my students it's really important to do all these things that you have to do, your responsibilities as a citizen. One of them is to pay your property taxes. I pay my property taxes. It's just a part of what we do. But why is it important? Like, why do we don't just do it because, you know, the law says we do it. We do it because, in my case, the important thing to me is the money goes into schools, right? I'm a teacher as well as the president of United Teachers of New Orleans. It's Black History Month in New Orleans, right? Most of the Black children in the city go to public schools. And public schools have had an important role in nurturing that culture which we all associate with New Orleans, the music, the food, the architecture. All of that is put in jeopardy by Folgers' refusal, right? Folgers' refusal to pay their taxes. If we look at, the business community also in this city talks about how they need talented people to be, young people to be developed so they can work in their business so they don't have to keep relocating people to New Orleans, right? The Folgers' decision is also jeopardizing that, the development of talented young people to come out of our schools to work in local businesses. And third, an issue which I talk about all the time with my members, the people I represent in the union, is teachers are leaving the profession because of pay. Carlos referred this before. Teachers and paraprofessionals and school support staff, they need to be paid more. We all need to be paid more. It's one of the big reasons why teachers are leaving the profession or leaving the city. And it's hard to attract new talent. So all of those things are important. I know in Folgers' ad, they say they don't give a damn about their bad reputation. That's the song they're playing through the whole video. But is that really what they think? Because this is really tarnishing their reputation. And so, Folger, I would encourage you to wake up and pay up.
Thank you, Dave. You'll notice a voice that's been very strong supporter of this and a leader is City Council Vice President Helena Marino, and she's doing her job today and unable to be with us. She is at the State Police Lab meeting about rapid DNA testing and getting that on board for New Orleans. But she did give us a brief statement that I would like to share with you this afternoon. Good afternoon. I apologize for not being able to attend in person and appreciate that my statement in support of Together New Orleans is being read. Today we say again that we've said it, what we've said before. Folgers must pay what it owes. The citizens of New Orleans deserve a corporate neighbor, a neighbor that respects the law and contributes to our community's greatest needs. It's fair, it's just, and it's right. The people of New Orleans are asked every year to pay their property taxes. And all we're asking of the Folgers Corporation is that they don't skirt theirs and that they pay their property tax. This is money we could be using on critical priorities like public safety, our streets, affordable housing. Thanks to Governor Edwards, a few years ago, we were able to take control of the Industrial Tax Exemption Program and authored strong local guidelines to ensure we only grant exemptions if corporations meet job creation and local economic development goals. Amen. Folgers has met guidelines in the past, and the council has fairly granted those exemptions. But the Folgers exemption in question now failed these tests, and the council voted it down. Yet the company continues to seek a way around the ruling. Our resolve is unchanged. Our ruling stands, and it is critical that any attempts to circumvent the council's authority be denied. Thank you, Together New Orleans, and countless advocates for staying in this fight. We will push to ensure that the people of New Orleans are not taken advantage of. Thank you, Helena Marino, City Council Vice President. Now finally, we would just like to conclude with something we all know all too well. For many years in our very rich state, have you noticed? Who is like number one and number two in petrochemicals? We are. Who's number one in salt production? We are. Who has five of the largest ports in the state of Louisiana? We do. We have tremendous wealth and we have Folgers. Why are we so poor? One of the clear reasons is that these industrial tax exemptions were handed out like cotton candy at a fair for nothing. Together New Orleans and several others have worked to change that, and in 2016 it changed. Now, as Councilwoman Marino said, there has to be a good reason for an exemption. Job creation, you're bringing a new business here, we're all about it. You don't just get an exemption because you're wealthy enough to take people to Ruth Chris Steakhouse and cut your own deal. That's the way things worked in this state. Two sets of rules, one for the big and powerful, and another for all of us. That has come to an end in 2016, but it's something we must stay on board with. Folgers, you're a member of our community. You should be first in line. You should be proud to pay these property taxes. You should have a press conference saying, look at us. We want to be first in line for public schools. We want to be first in line for these road and bridges. We want to be first in line for fire and police. We want to be the first citizen in the state to do our part for our city. We're asking you, Governor, and we're asking you, State Board of Commerce and Industry, to respect and do what you said you were going to do, which is respect local decisions. City Council, School Board, Sheriff. Thank you. God bless you. Woo!